Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about what is that is alkaline earth metals and what are the elements that is belonging to group 2, as well as we have also discussed about the periodic trends. And now we are going to talk about the chemical reactivity of group 2 elements. So what are those? Let me talk about that. So talking about the chemical reactivity, basically this metals or this S block elements, they are basically very reactive to like oxygen, hydrogen or water. So regarding this, we are going to talk about that is each of it, that is what will happen if this metals are reacted with that of that is oxygen. After that, we will talk about what will happen if these metals will be reacting with that of that is H2O, hydrogen, and at the last halogen. So let me talk about the first point, that is we are going to talk about that is what is the reaction of this alkali metals towards oxygen. So talking about the group 2 elements, they have basically less or low ionization enthalpy compared to that of the group 1 elements, that is alkali metals. So even this are having a low ionization enthalpy, still they are reactive towards the oxygen, and that's the reason that most of the metals of this group, that is if I talk about that is barium and magnesium, they don't react with oxygen because they are kinetically inert, but still they could form oxide, and that's the reason while burning this kind of metals like magnesium or beryllium, they form a very bright illuminescence, and that's the reason that we are going to talk about that how does the reaction takes place. So suppose if I'm talking about that is beryllium as in metal in this case, suppose so the beryllium is the metal that will easily react with that of the oxygen. But the thing is, we have to play a very vital role in balancing the reaction. So it indicates that that is 2 moles of beryllium will react with that of oxygen, so as to produce a metal oxide. And those metal oxide are basically, we could write it over here as 2 moles of beryllium oxide. Suppose through this example, if we are talking about the oxidation state, and if you know that is the oxygen, that is the one which has an oxidation state of -2. So that's the reason in this case the metal will have an oxidation state of +2. So that's the reason most of this metals have an oxidation state of +2. So this is what I have mentioned, the reaction where beryllium is been reacted with that of that is oxygen, and it has been ignited so as to produce that is the metal oxide, that is BeO. So this is how the reaction takes place. So and this kind of oxide that have been formed on the metal surface, and this is what I want to talk about. And now let me talk about the another example, that what happens if magnesium is been reacted with that of oxygen. So as we have discussed earlier also, that is they are very much reactive, and because these are belonging to S block elements, and they are very much electropositive, and because of which that is magnesium can easily react with oxygen. But what we have to do is we have to make a pieces of this metals, and then only the reaction will happen, because this metals occupy oxygen on its surface so as to form metal oxide. And now suppose if we try to ignite it, so what will happen is 2 moles of magnesium atoms, they will combine with that of the oxygen molecule so as to form that is 2 moles of magnesium oxide. So this is the reaction that takes place for these alkaline earth metals. So this was regarding the reaction with that of oxygen. And now let us move on to the next one, that is what will happen if an alkaline earth metal is being reacted with that of water. So now let me discuss about the reaction of the alkaline earth metals with that of the water molecule. So talking about the first element, that is beryllium. So beryllium is a kind of an element which is not reactive with that of the water. Suppose if we talk about sodium, and as you know that sodium reacts vigorously with that of water, and that's the reason that we should not insert sodium in water, because it is very highly reactive. So similarly, because even this alkaline earth metals are the S block elements, and even they are very much reactive towards the water, but the thing is, if you talk about the first element, that is beryllium, so beryllium is not reactive at all with water. So that is what the different behavior of beryllium is with that of water. So now let me discuss about the general reaction, that is whenever an alkaline earth metal is been reacted with that of water. So let me represent it with this way, that is suppose if I am talking about an alkaline earth metal, suppose if I am representing it with M, and if I am reacting it with that of water, that is H2O. So the thing that we have to do is we have observed that is whenever these metals they react with water, they form hydroxides, and that's the reason that it will form hydroxide. That is, and since we also know that is they have a valency of 2 or they have an oxidation state of +2, and that's the reason that we could find that is MgOH twice is been produced, and along with that of that is hydrogen gas. But here we have to balance the reaction, and that's the reason we have mentioned in this way. So now the main thing is talking about the magnesium. So magnesium is also very reactive with that of the water, but the thing is we have to warm it. So whenever a magnesium is being treated with a warm or a hot water, then the magnesium hydroxide has been produced. So, and while talking about the other elements, that is whether it would be strontium, that is calcium, and that is radium, suppose. So they are very much highly reactive with that of water, and they even react at cold temperature. So let me give an example of that, what happens when basically magnesium is reacted with that of water. So therefore magnesium along with that of 2 moles of H2, I suppose if we heat it, then only we will form that is MgOH twice will be obtained along with that of liberation of H2 gas. So in this case, we have also discussed that is the barium is basically inert with that of the H2, and talking about the next thing, and that as we move down to the group, so those group elements, they don't need heat so as to react with that of water. Even they can react at cold condition also. So suppose if we react that is strontium with cold water, still the reaction will happen, and we could get that is strontium hydroxide. And with the evolution of hydrogen gas. So this was regarding the reaction with that of H2, and now let us move on to the next one, that is what will happen if this alkaline earth metals are being reacted with that of that is hydrogen. So now let me discuss about that is the reaction of H2 with alkaline earth metals. So again, let me talk about the first element, that is beryllium. So beryllium is not that much reactive that is with hydrogen. So as it was not reactive with that of water molecule, so it is not even that much reactive with hydrogen molecule so as to produce a hydride. So even that is an exception case of the group 2 element, and that is if I'm talking about beryllium. And now let us discuss about the other elements rather than that of the beryllium. So the other elements, that is if I represent it with M, so that could be that is magnesium, calcium, strontium, and the rest of the element rather than beryllium. So whenever they react with hydrogen, they form a particular hydride, that is this one would be MH2. I would write it in this way. So therefore these are the metal hydrides that are being produced. So let me give an example, that is suppose if I consider that is magnesium, suppose. And if magnesium is being treated with that of hydrogen, so now the reaction will produce or the reaction will go on, and so as to produce that is MgH2 or magnesium hydride. So along with we could also take an example of calcium. So whenever calcium is being treated with hydrogen, it forms calcium hydride. The thing is we have to give a pure hydrogen to react with this kind of alkali metals, and that's the reason we'll obtain the product as an hydride. So as we have discussed, that is beryllium is not reactive with that of the hydrogen molecule, but still we could obtain a beryllium hydride. So we can't obtain it directly while treating hydrogen with that of beryllium because it is very inert to that of the hydrogen molecule. So we are going to try an alternative method so as to prepare beryllium hydride. So that is basically a barium chloride. If you take beryllium chloride and if you try to reduce it, or if you try to react it with that is lithium aluminum hydride, in that reaction basically we could form that is a beryllium hydride, and the reaction can be written as follows that I am mentioning over here. That is suppose BeCl2, suppose if we have take BeCl2 and if we are treating it with that of lithium aluminum hydride, and as we know that lithium aluminum hydride is used as a catalyst also. So therefore in this reaction basically if we observe, that is if we take a stoichiometry of that is 2 moles of BeCl2 and if we react it with that of that is lithium aluminum hydride, then the product that we could obtain is basically 2 moles of BeH2 along with that of the other products like LiCl. And so this is the reaction that I have mentioned over here, that is we can produce that is BeH2 plus LiCl along with that of AlCl3. So this is how we could obtain that is beryllium hydride by indirect method, and that is how basically beryllium hydride has been produced. So this was the reaction regarding the alkaline earth metals when it has been reacted with that of the pure hydrogen molecule. So that's it, and now let us move on to the last one, that is what will happen if the alkaline earth metals is been treated with that of the halogen molecule. So now talking about that is the reaction of the halogen on the alkaline earth metals. As we know that the alkaline earth metals are basically electropositive, and this halogen atoms, or if I talk about like chlorine, fluorine, so they are basically more electronegative, and that's the reason the reaction will occur in a rapid condition. So the thing is, suppose if I take any kind of the alkaline earth metal, suppose if I am representing it with M, and if I am reacting it with any kind of the halogen molecule, so the reaction is vigorous in such a way that we could obtain that is respective metal halide. So this is what we have obtained over here. And now let me represent it with the help of an example so that we could discuss that how this kind of molecules have been produced, that is metal halides are been produced. Suppose if I'm talking about calcium, so whenever the calcium is been treated with, suppose if I talk about like chlorine, so the reaction occurs in such a way that we could obtain basically calcium chloride, that is CaCl2. So the reaction is vigorous, or else we have to provide certain kind of energy in the form of heat, and then only the product would be obtained. So now since it is applicable for most of the metals except beryllium, so again, suppose if we have to obtain a beryllium, so we have to provide certain kind of conditions, or we can prepare it indirectly. Suppose if we have to prepare that is beryllium chloride or beryllium halide. So it has been observed that suppose if we are using that is a reagent that is basically, that is if we use that is ammonium fluoroberylate, and if we try to decompose it, or if we try to heat it, so therefore the product that we could obtain is basically BeF2 along with that of the other molecules like 2 moles of NH4. So this is how we could obtain that is beryllium fluoride. And talking about how can we prepare that is barium chloride, so it doesn't react with any kind of halogen directly, so therefore we have to produce it in indirect method. So that is beryllium oxide is been treated along with carbon, along with that of that is the chlorine molecule, and in this case basically we could easily prepare that is BeCl2 along with that of carbon monoxide. So this is how it has been prepared. So therefore there is more thing about that is the beryllium that we have discussed in this case, that is it is showing an abnormal behavior compared to that of the other elements of the group 2. So we are going to discuss about that also, that is what is the different behavior of and why does it behaves differently compared to that of the other elements. So for now this is what we have discussed, that is the different kind of reaction that could be exhibited by the group 2 elements or by the alkaline earth metals. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know the various concept behind this one. So I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.